Hey y'all, welcome back to the channel. So we are continuing on our British comedy journey.
Oh yeah.
So far we've done Al Murray, and so many of you have left comments after comment after comment on what we should react to next.
Absolutely.
So what we got today, babe?
So today we are checking out, I believe this gentleman, his name is Dave Allen. Mm-hmm. This was a request from the comment section.
Okay.
So we are relying on the comment section for you guys to point us in the right direction for some awesome British comedians. But let's go ahead and check him out and let's see how funny he is. Let's go.
About Adam and Eve.
Adam and Eve. That's right.
I am what you would, might call a practicing atheist.
Oh.
I'm quite happy to be an atheist because I think actually God likes atheists better.
Mm.
We never ask him for anything. We're not bothering him all the time saying, oh God, please help me, I'm a distant. And as a practicing atheist, there's certain things that I travel around the world, and no matter where I go, somebody called Gideon leaves me this book to read.
Mm. Gideon?
It's an Irish book because it says it all began at the beginning. There are certain things that, when I read the Bible, and I do read the Bible, that I find difficult to understand. I mean, if God has been there forever, what was he doing before he got to us?
Mm.
Oh.
Good question.
I mean, what was he out there doing? Was he sitting there going, bored today? What did I do?
I mean,
suddenly from nowhere, he suddenly decided to create a world. I'll make a world. That's what I'll do. Make a world. Yes, that's what I'll do. Rivers, seas, boom, mountains. Everything's there. I want a garden. I'd like a nice garden. Quack! Garden me. Hate gardening. Need a garden. Ah, garden. Spit and dust. Adam. And he, Adam, never once says, where in the name of God did I come from? I mean, he's 40 years of age. He has no child, he has no recall, he doesn't say, how did I get here?
Mm.
But he's quite happy, he just kind of trundles around the garden, working away. And God is looking at him. And he sees that Adam is happy.
Oh, he's wrong for that.
I didn't put him there to be happy. I'll put a stop to that. God, during the night, sneaks down my feet.
Oh, man.
Doesn't ask, doesn't request, doesn't... Steals it. His rib.
Mm.
And from his rib, he makes woman. And Adam wakes up in the morning. He's a real thicky. He's lying there. And there's somebody else. He doesn't say, where did you come from?
Mm.
How the hell did you get here? Where did you get those lumps? Just goes out and goes gardening. And God comes down and has a conversation with Eve and tells her that she can eat of any fruit in the tree in the whole garden with the exception of one fruit tree. He's talking to a woman.
Of course we're going to eat
the... He actually tells her not to eat of the fruit.
And the tree of knowledge.
Said, which tree can I eat? He said, that one over there. He points it out to her. And when he goes and hides, and she sneaks up to the tree, and a snake comes down and has a conversation. A snake. Now, if I see a snake, I'll back off. If one starts talking, I'll crap myself. And the snake actually convinces her to eat the apple. And she eats the apple. And when she eats the apple, she learns shame. That's what happens when you eat apples. Now, she's not ashamed that she's disobeyed God or that she's eaten the apple. She's ashamed
that she's naked.
Here, one part of her body. All. She becomes ashamed of that area of the body. Now, why that area? Why not her elbow? Her nose. Do you actually realize that if Eve had been ashamed of her nose, every woman in the world now would be ashamed of your noses? Mm. You'd all be sitting here tonight with little nose knickers on.
Nose knickers. Butt naked.
Men would be in nightclubs watching totally naked ladies with G-strings on. Oh. Take them off. Oh, I saw a nose. And this is the book. This is the book that you'll go into court and place your hand upon.
Oh.
Oh. Damn.
I swear to tell the truth.
Damn.
Oh.
Oh, man. Wow. Oh.
That was so good.
That was good.
This was so good. I love
his delivery.
I love his delivery.
His punchlines and his deliveries were spot on.
I love everything about this because he's talking about something that is very controversial.
Right.
It's really hard to have conversations about religion and politics. Right. And the way he did this, it made you think, it made you laugh, and you walk away with questions. You walk away with, you know, like a new mindset, really. And to think about something that, a lot of times, because I grew up in the church, you cannot question the Bible at all. I remember asking questions because a lot of it didn't make sense. And it was like, you do not question. You believe it. Now, when you go to school and they tell you something you can ask questions, even especially when it don't make any sense.
Right.
But if that don't make any sense, you can't question it.
Right.
So good. What you thought, babe?
Yeah, I thought this was great, especially for a first-time reaction to Dave Allen's work. As I said, his punchlines, his delivery was really good. He's just spot on. And he has all the qualities of a comedian that I enjoy. So we're definitely going to have to check out some more for him.
This just made me so excited because I actually love having conversations like this.
Yeah.
But I made a mistake of having a similar conversation at work.
Yikes.
And because reading the Bible as an adult versus being a child, some things I'm like, this don't add up because, you know, Adam and Eve weren't the only people in the garden. I remember, talking to my coworkers about it.
Mm.
It did not go over well.
Oh, yikes.
You got to add a little comedy in there. That was my mistake.
Make them laugh. Right. Well, guys, leave your thoughts down below in the comment section and go ahead and put us on to some more more work from Dave Allen. As always, subscribe to the channel for more comedy, and we'll see you guys in our next video.
Ta-ta.
Take care. Peace.